Okay, so let's do an easy example where I'm inserting data into an initially empty splay tree. And remember that every time I insert or access a data item, I want to rotate the tree so that that data item is rotated all the way back up to the root according to the splay tree rotation rules. So let's start with inserting a 5. Okay, so here's my initial splay tree, which is at the root, obviously. And then we'll insert a 10. Okay, here is my X and my P. So I'll need to do a single rotation. Okay, and now let's insert a 15. So I have 10, 5, 15, just like so. And of course, I need to do this rotation here. So that will give me 15, 10, and 5, like so. Okay, next element insert, let's say we insert a 3. So 15, 10, 5, and 3. Here is my X, P, and G. So I clearly have a zigzag structure here. So that will then do my double rotation so that I have X, P, and G going down, like so. Okay, let us now insert a 4. All right, so at this point I have my X, P, and G, which is a zigzag rotation. So I first rotate around this edge to give 3, 4, 5, and then I rotate around the 3, 4 edge. So I end up with 15, 4, and the 3, 5, and 10, like so. Okay, let's insert now a 21. So I'll have the 21 right here. Okay, so I have G, P, X right here. So that's a zigzag construction. So that means X was going to get rotated after two rotations. X will be up at the top. So 15, 4, 3, like so. And then X is up at the top with my 21. And then 15. Oops, I inserted this in the wrong place, didn't I? Let's try again. There we go. That looks better. Okay, that looks much better. Let's cross this off. Okay, so here I've got just the P and X, so I need to rotate the 21 up to the root. Well, that looks a lot better, doesn't it? Okay, let us now insert, how about a 7. Okay, so with the 7, I have the G, P, X, I have the zigzag. So I first rotate around this edge, so I get the 5, 7, 10, and then I rotate around the 5, 7 edge, so that 7 will be up in this position here. So I will get, let me just draw that first, and then I'll add the other stuff, 7, 10, and 5. Okay, because this is intermediate yet, right? 4 and 3. And then here's my 15 and my 21. Okay, now I have, here's my X at this point, and I have here a zigzag construction, so PG. So I'm going to need to rotate around this first, so that'll give me 15, 7, 4, and then I rotate around the 15 and the 7, so that's going to give me, let's see, rotate around the 15, 7, so that'll give me the 7, the 4, and the 15 going this way. Okay, so it gives me 10 here, 5, and 3. I'm doing the rotations very fast. You should probably sketch them out on a separate piece of paper. So then up here is my 21. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 3, 4, 5, lives. Okay, I have everything. Now at this point, my new node that I just inserted was my 7. So I'm right here. And I have my node and my parent. Parent is the root. So I just need to do a single rotation there. So I have 7, 21. And then coming off the 7, I have the 4, 3, and 5. And then the 15, 10 will come off the 21, right? 15 and 10. So there is my final splay tree at this point after inserting 5, 10 and splaying at each point. 15, 3, 4, 21, and then 7.